Well, what an amazing welcome to a celebration of Gayle's life and mourning of her passing. Ted gave me the real honor of inviting me to come up here and share a few memories of Gayle and welcome folks to this bittersweet event. It's amazing to be up here and to see all of Gayle's loved ones. My name is Kirk. And I didn't know Gayle as long as many of the people in this park today, and maybe even as well, but I was privileged to have an opportunity to get to know her and to help tell her story in a way that changed our country for the better. And I took away from Gayle, really, more than anything, her fighting spirit, that she was indomitable in the face of really difficult obstacles and challenges, and a journey that would have crushed, I think, a lesser person who didn't have that kind of fighting spirit, who didn't have that kind of warrior soul. I was on the way down here today, and I looked over the testimony that Gayle gave in Owen's trial in 2012, when she was battling cancer, when she was walking into a very intimidating environment, an environment designed to be intimidating. That's why, you know, we wear capes and funny costumes, and the judge sits way up above you, and, you know, it's all very solemn. It's designed to impress upon you the seriousness of what's happening. But it didn't faze her for a second. She told a story of a life's journey that was really incredible to hear, battling serious illnesses from the age of 3 months on, and battling them from the age of 13 with the use of cannabis and other natural herbs as a supplement to her cannabis therapies. And not being overcome by her illnesses, but using them to help other people overcome the challenges that they faced in their lives. And she told a story of obstacles. You know, at one point she talked about going in to speak to try to find a new doctor here in Victoria after coming from Salt Spring Island, and leaving a difficult relationship, and those challenges. And the doctor, upon hearing her serious medical conditions, and as part of the interview, asked her, did she smoke? And she said, well, I don't smoke tobacco, I smoke cannabis. And the doctor said, well, we don't want your kind to get sick. And, you know, those challenges will stop you in your tracks if you don't have that kind of fighting spirit to keep on. And she did keep on. And she found supportive physicians, and she educated people. And she taught people lessons about the way to approach life and the way to carry yourself. I learned a lot from Gayle in the time that I had an opportunity to know her. And so I think what I'd just like to say here today and to leave folks with before Ted comes up is that we're here to mourn her passing, but more than that, I think, to celebrate who she was, what she stood for, and to never stop in our quest to help others and to bring goodness and light into people's lives that we have the privilege of touching. She certainly did that for me and so many others here, and she'll be missed. Ted, you want to come on up next?
given to us the last couple of years in particular. It's been very difficult, especially since Gayle brought me back. The last 3 years of at times, some of the most rewarding, and yet obviously some of the most difficult in my life. And so many of you have reached out and helped me and Gayle in every way possible. You can imagine having a strong and more caring and loving group of people in my life. I just feel so blessed. It's been this terrible situation. I feel like one of the luckiest people that's ever walked on this planet. None of us can avoid losing loved ones, living and dying in the fight. I just feel so incredibly grateful. And I got to meet Gayle, the beautiful, for these 13 years. Especially through these last 10 years we've lived together. It's been an incredible journey. It's been so much fun sharing with all of you and all the different experiences. And things that we got up to. It was really magical, especially the first 5 years before she lost her breast. But even then, after she got back on her feet, we had an amazing year and a half traveling around the country and going to Jamaica and other places. Well, Canada, obviously. But recently, we've been coast to coast and met so many beautiful, loving, caring people in this country. I'm just so blessed for that, for this experience I've had. Life has many challenges and opportunities that fall into your lap. And when Gayle fell into my lap, I didn't realize what that meant. And sometimes we all need to just embrace that chance and that opportunity like we both did 10 years ago when we got together. I just, I'm so blessed to have so many amazing memories. We've been as much as we could into that 10 years, I tell you. And so, belongings to look after, and I brought a bunch of them today, and some of them are here for you to look at, I'm hoping that everyone here today takes something, and I've got at the end of this table here a huge pile of hats that I need one today. And at the end of this table here, there's a big pile of scarves and shawls and stuff like that. Please, ladies, every one of you should take a shawl. And I have way too many. And I have a wardrobe, like a whole bedroom full of clothing. If you fit Gayle's clothes, if you fit me up close, please get in contact with me. I really have like a mountain of hippie girl clothes. I don't want to sell them or give them to thrift store, but if you folks don't come and take them, then that's what I'm going to do. Because I have no choice, I can't, right? It's something that tomorrow, for those that can make it to Cobble Hill, certainly, you know, the ladies that can fit into her clothes, I'm going to encourage them to take boxes of them. There will be estate sales in December, but in the meantime, if you do fit her clothes, possibly your daughter that does or something, like, please come to Cobble Hill and let me give you some clothing. But certainly, if the hats and scarves, I'd love it if I didn't take any home. The rest of the stuff here is obviously not meant to give away today necessarily, although I'm giving out a lot of the crystals and finishes made and stuff. So possible, but certainly that I am wanting to get out today. For those that are coming tomorrow, I'm having an event tomorrow at 4:20 in Commonwealth, at Arrowhead, Commonwealth Retreat. We're going to be ordering pizza for supper, so you don't have to worry about supper. We're just going to do a mass pizza order tomorrow. And we have a fire in the teepee for the evening as well, and there's lots of room to crash in the trailer if you need a floor space. The teepee's going to have a fire all night as well, so you're welcome to spend the night here with me. I'm not sleeping for the night. Tonight, though, as well, we have rented the Sunset Room, which is a wonderful non-alcohol venue that's just on the Inner Harbor, so you've got a nice patio with what it really holds off. We have a tent there at the very least, which would be nice to sit in the Inner Harbor and talk while listening to some of our wonderful friends, DJs, Deanna, and I haven't seen you around yet. We had a couple of friends from the mainland here to play music, and with them, Ari, and Paul, and they're all in the lineup. So it'll be a wonderful ganja-infested playlist tonight, so you're welcome to join us there. I'd like to sing a couple of Cannabis carols with you guys. Yeah.
Booklets. If you could go around and maybe give some to somebody else to go the other direction. Gayle and I did a lot of wild and crazy things. That was kind of what we prided ourselves on. And so one of the things that we did was we made up this little booklet of Cannabis carols, and in December, I can't remember the date, but if you get our newspaper, the Cannabis Digest, which, as I've often said, the newspaper, the Cannabis Digest, would not likely even be here without Gayle. She really inspired that. But one of the other things that we did together that we just love to do, and again, the date, I think it's like December 23rd or something. The date is coming up next month, and we just go around downtown Victoria and smoke joints and sing songs about cannabis for a while. So it's really a heck of a lot of fun to do. And again, it's coming up next month, I think the Wednesday before Christmas. So I guess the first one I'd like to start with, if you just open it up, on page 2, it's rather appropriate for today, Deck the Courts. I think most of you would be familiar with the Christmas song Deck the Halls that this goes with, so I'll just make sure everybody's had a chance to get a carol book in their hand. Oh, Owen, the divine American, gonna get one. So, sure. Yeah, we'll get a couple songs in. Deck the Courts, I'll give you guys a countdown of 3. 3, 2, 1.
Deck the Courts with lots of ganja, la 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 la. 'Tis the season to pray ganja, la 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 la. Don we now our hands for barrel, la 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 la. Sing the ancient cannabis carol, la 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 la. Smoke the blazing split before us, la 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 la. Seekers, la 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 la.
That was really lovely. Yeah, let's go for Rudolph. That's like page 6 or something, 5 or 6. Rudolph is one of our oldest and most favorite songs. Okay, so count down to 3 again. 3, 2, 1.
You know time warp and Big Brother Dirt and Bernie's. Ignore and hashish and oil and cookies. But do you recall the most famous outdoor of all? Rudolph the Red-Haired Outdoor was a very sticky strain.
Songs here,
but
I'm gonna go with "Jah Bless You, Healthy Cannabis." It's a long one, but I really, really love it. I did mean to say earlier, feel free to take as many pictures and videos and things of this as you like, the displays and stuff. Nothing is sacred here in that sense. In fact, you know, what is going to keep Gayle alive is our memories, is our pictures, our stories, our videos. And so the more of today and Gayle's life that you can keep alive, the better. And so feel free to take as many pictures as you feel like. But yeah, so it's near the back, "Jah Bless You, Healthy Cannabis." I'm trying to even remember what the original was for this one. I'll sing a little bit so you guys catch the tune. "Jah bless you, healthy cannabis, let freedom pay your way." So that's the tune. It's all good. You got it now. So here we go. On 3. 1, 2, 3.
"Jah bless you, healthy cannabis, let freedom pay your way. Save us all from legal drugs and stop the war someday. Oh, tidings of cookies and butts, cookies and butts. Oh, tidings of cookies and butts. In Victoria, Canada, this glorious land is grown, and all the healthy benefits are still not fully known. Cookies and butts, cookies.
And the last one is one that I didn't write myself, but it is really probably my favorite now. It's right in the very back, Cannabis Puff, by my friend Carol Puff. Okay, so here we go in 3, 2, 1.
Cannabis, cannabis, cannabis pop. Cannabis seeds and cannabis trees. Grow and show them nothing yet. No, you ain't seen nothing yet. Cannabis, cannabis, cannabis pop. Cannabis stokes and cannabis smokes. Huffing, huffing, cannabis all.
People that want to come up and say something. I didn't want to have us speaking through 420. I wanted us puffing tart through 420. And so before we get to that, we will have 42 seconds of silence at 420. I'll get the DJ to pause the music. But before that, and to conclude this, I was going to invite our dear friend Neil Magnuson up to sing O Cannabis for us.
Thanks, Ted. And actually, when you get to be kind of last, everything's kind of been said. And one of the things I was going to say, Ted, is we appreciate so much the efforts you put in. I can't express that enough. And everybody else that helped. Ted, you gave us so much strength to deal with this ourselves, because this has been also very hard to deal with for everyone who loved Gayle. And you helped us through that in such amazing ways. I can't imagine how you did that. And you know, Gayle was an ordinary person, but she had an extraordinary passion, and that led her to live a life that transcends the normal permanence of death. And she will live on for generations through all that she has inspired all of us here and so many more, and for so many generations. That's what happens when you live a life that's true to yourself and the passion that you feel, and when you feel empathy for other people. And in tribute to her, I'd like to do O Cannabis.
O Cannabis, the sacred plant of peace, with healing powers, it's helped our eyes to see. And with glowing joints, we've made the points that the true north should be free. And with wise red eyes, we've criticized the war against our family. Gayle, we love you so, for your beautiful heart and soul. Gayle, Cannabis, we stand here high and proud for thee. O Cannabis, the sacred plant of peace.
Okay, again, you know, tonight at 9 o'clock, we're going to be having fun at the Sunset Room, getting some energy out. So please invite your friends. It's by donation, so if somebody says they don't have any money, just let tell them they can come down and celebrate with us. And then tomorrow, for those that can make it up island at 4:20, we're having a final gathering up on our property in Commonville. Everyone's welcome. Again, another final reminder, I have shawls over here, hats over here. Please take something. And other than that, I just love you all so, so very much. I really appreciate you coming together here. Yes. Take care, everyone.